Here we go. Best of luck, guys. And your first question, Pat. Nosology is a branch of science that deals with the classification and description of what? Insects, stars, or diseases?
Well, I think entomology is the main insect science. And there are all sorts of different sciences concerned with stars. I know that nosocomial diseases, there's a phrase, nosocomial, an adjective that describes, might be a disease acquired in hospital or a disease. Yes, I don't think it's stars, I don't think it's insects, and I think there's some reason for thinking it might be diseases. So I'll say diseases.
It is correct, Pat, yes. Another good start. And David, on a two-dimensional graph, which letter of the alphabet normally signifies the horizontal axis, X, Y, or Z?
Well, the horizontal axis, the abscissa, is usually the X axis.
Good one for you, that is correct, yes, X axis. Second question each, Pat. What was the name given to the unusual species of shark discovered in 1976, a filter feeder known for its distinctive large bulbous head and rubbery lips? The megamouth shark, the colossal shark, or the whale jaw shark?
Well, there are a great many varieties of shark, so all three of those might be. I know there is a megamouth shark that hangs around in Arctic and Antarctic areas, I believe, and it's quite an event when one of them is seen. So I think I'll have to go with megamouth.
Megamouth shark is correct, Pat, yes. Nothing to be afraid of, it's a filter feeder. It won't bite. Two for you, David. Which noble gas with the atomic number 54 is traditionally used in cinema projectors to produce a bright white light? Krypton, argon, or xenon?
Right, it's not argon. Argon's atomic number is something like 18, I think. I've certainly never heard of this sort of light, and I'm trying to remember which has got the larger atomic number. I'm in two minds. I think that I will go for xenon.
Lost the first three. You don't want to go behind in this one. Eggheads?
I think it's xenon.
Xenon?
Yeah.
It is the right answer, David. It's all square in this round, 2-2. And it comes up all the time, the periodic tables and the periodic numbers. Is this something you, if you're going to be any good at quizzing, you've got to have a fairly decent knowledge of?
Yeah.
You've got to know all the, most of the symbols, okay. And the atomic numbers do help.
Do you test each other on them?
No.
No,
there aren't limits.
I like the way Daphne goes, no, like, that's sad. You're quizzes, for goodness sake. That's what you do. OK, well, it's all square, and we move on to a third question each. This is yours, Pat. In the 1860s, who saved the French silk industry by finding the cause of a disease that attacked silkworms? Is it Antoine Lavoisier, Louis Pasteur, or Henri Mouton?
Well, poor old Antoine Lavoisier wasn't doing anything because they'd chopped his head off in the revolution. Pasteur was an early expert in bacteriology, diseases, causes of diseases. So he's the right sort of chap. He did lots of work for industry. He did work on anthrax, rabies. I think it's Pasteur versus Mouton, and I'll go with Pasteur.
That is correct, Pat. Louis Pasteur, and the cause of a disease that attacked silkworms in the 1860s. So, David, you know what you've got to do with this one. In 1958, James Van Allen discovered the belts of highly energetic charged particles trapped in the magnetic field of the Earth that are named after him using data obtained by which US satellite program? Discoverer, Skylab, or Explorer? In 1958, James Van Allen discovered the belts of highly energetic charged particles trapped in the magnetic field of the Earth that are named after him using data obtained by which US satellite program?
I would have thought that it would require quite a lot of data to get that sort of information. So we might be looking at something which is, if you like, a long-term scientific project, because it was a lab in the sky. I'll go for Skylab.
Question said 1958.
Oh!
I did read it twice. The crucial thing in quizzing is to listen to the entirety of the question too early for Skylab, isn't it? Way too early.
It's
Explorer, which, bad luck for you, David, there. Didn't listen to the question in full.
Just silly.
And, Pat, you've won the round. Well, David, that's misfortune handed the round to Pat. Means, Pat, you've won music, geography, arts and books and science, amassing 4 points so far. And no points so far for David. We face our final category before the final round. This one is sport. And, Pat, you get to choose again. Do you want to go first or second?
I'll go first, please.